So data are important in public health and healthcare collaborations because almost everything that we do is in some way informed by data. Whether you're buying a couch, whether you're deciding what car to buy, you try to collect as much information or data as you can before you make that decision. But in healthcare, our data are kind of separate, right? With the advent of electronic medical records, we have tremendously good outcome data. We know where the people are who have diabetes. We know where they've been diagnosed. We can map that. And in public health, we have some really good contextual data. And, you know, about the parks and where are their fast food outlets and where are their walking trails. And if we can actually bring these two things together. So for the public health side, we don't have that outcome data in real time. We don't have it at the block group level, at the street address level. So we need that from primary care. And for primary care, I mean, we all know that when we sit with our physician, rarely is information about the crime rate or some of the challenges in our neighborhoods. That's not integrated into the electronic medical records. But if we can bring these two things together, we actually can improve population health with the information that we have to really inform policy and planning. So for public health, the data that we have to really understand outcomes is often old and it's not at the right level of geographic acuity. So take something like a statewide diabetes rate. When you ask a state, hey, what is the diabetes rate? You're getting data from the behavioral risk factor surveillance system. It's typically 2 years old, and it's from a data set that has a 35% response rate. And the question that we use is, has a medical provider ever told you that you have diabetes? So it's probably not the most reliable source of information, but it's what we have. And it's typically at a state level, maybe at a county level, but not really where we want it, which is at the street level, the address level. And so we need those data. That's a huge problem. And then for primary care, telling someone that they have to walk if they're obese, well, that makes some sense from a purely clinical situation, but what if you can't walk because there are no streetlights or no sidewalks, or you live in an area with high crime? If that information was integrated into the electronic medical record, you could actually then change your behavioral counseling for your patient to give them a better opportunity to actually act on your recommendation. And so not having these data, not sharing these data, I mean, that's the real limitation to us moving forward in population health. When you think about what we have right now as far as individual health, we can go down to our genetic code. If your mother has breast cancer, we can look at their daughter's genetic code, we can look at the genetic code of the actual cancer, and we can make decisions based on that level of acuity. And that's how healthcare has developed in the US. But for our communities, what's the level of detail that we really have to understand health in place? So we, for the individual, we have this tremendous cadre of tests and procedures that we can use. But sometimes the best we have for the community is a community level measure. And a community level measure is kind of like walking into a doctor and saying, I have cancer, but I don't know where it is. I don't know what type it is. And here's my blood work from 2 years ago. And we should demand the same level of care and information for our communities that we do for ourselves. Because our health is indelibly linked to our communities. And if we don't have the same level of information, how can we be expected to achieve the same level of health? So improving our access and use of data is going to take public health and primary care really coming together. On the primary care side, there are hospitals with competitive interests, why they wouldn't necessarily share data with a hospital in the same community who's a competitor. There are HIPAA issues, there are privacy issues, and we want to make sure that no one is getting, is no one is giving up their data that wouldn't want to. But on the same turn, public health has a long history of protecting privacy. I mean, remember, HIV and AIDS name reporting comes to the health department. So we have a long history of protecting information. And also, we can act as that third-party convener. But this is a very simple answer. It's going to be will. It's going to be the political will, the desire of these groups to work together to bring their information together for better outcomes.